things, but for different phases of life. But I mean, not someone who has done this unlearning thing specifically.
Have you thought about unlearning something specific ever?
Yeah, because when I moved sectors from journalism to PR, obviously I had to learn and unlearn stuff.
Okay.
So obviously that's what I was looking at.
Right. So ever came to your mind if you get some systematic method of unlearning, it might help you to achieve your task easily?
For me, it's been more learning on the job, testing it out on what I need to do. And then, you know, because I guess some of the stuff that I do is it's a high stake game. When I mean it's a high stake game, it's more about, you know, working with the largest of corporates. And then if there is a mistake in what I say, I mean, the repercussions are very fast. I need to be very careful in how I go about it. So at least till now, I guess we have been saved. I mean, obviously, you learn new things every time. Every time there is a crisis or every time there is, you know, how better that you could have managed things. So, yeah, I mean, you learn a bit. You learn something different. But so, I mean, I take it in that way. I take each day as a new learning process.
I think generally, yes, most of the people, what I find, they do new learning and they think unlearning will come automatically.
Mm.
So I think that is what you are also telling.
Yeah, because there are certain ways that I used to do things before that obviously won't help, but I can't unlearn it fully too, because I need to know about it so that I can recommend stuff to clients now. So it's not that I should be unlearning it completely. So that's where it's like a fine balance on how much I should unlearn and how much should I be using it, using things properly. It's like walking on a tightrope for that matter.
Before talking to me, have you ever heard that there is a book on unlearning?
No.
Talking to an author actually who has written book, and not today. I think I wrote a book on unlearning 15 years before, when nobody in the world ever thought of writing a book on unlearning. Now, a lot of people from UK, USA, and other places have come out with some kind of book, and they have written on unlearning. And I find most of them have written books on unlearning, mainly countering my arguments, if somebody has read it, because I have written my book, I know each every line basically, because I have not copied it from anywhere.
Maybe you may need to relook at that book and, you know, write a new book. I mean, for the new age.
That you see, my three books are there. First book came out in 2007. I mean, I wrote in 2005 around. And it was publishing took time around 2 years. So by 2007, first book was published. Then I met another publisher, basically. He was a learned Navy officer, and he helped me a lot to get it published. He even paid a publishing charge. And the second book was published in 2012.
Okay.
After around 5-7 years.
Yeah.
So that was basically when I wrote that book, even the title I gave for global networking, because by that time social sites and other things had come up. Then somebody advised ki you write a small book just giving the gist of what unlearning is all about. So my third book came around 2014, and my book got award also, best book award, from one of the institution in India, and that is what ISTD I was mentioning, you know.
Okay.
ISTD in their book award function, they awarded my book first prize. But for last 6 years, I have not written any book, basically because I'm looking for a readers for my writing.
So that's why I'm saying, so maybe you should...
There should be a publisher, distributor. There are a lot of business into it, actually. So if I am not getting those things, I cannot handle each and everything. So I have to get a partner basically for these things. You understand, I think. You are
So that's the reason why LinkedIn and Twitter becomes very important. It's sort of a self-branding. You don't need to rely on someone. It all depends on how well you are accepted or not.
In that I do it. If you go and see my LinkedIn profile, Facebook, Twitter, everywhere, na, I'm quite famous that way. But famous in a very local way. I mean, just local. I mean, all my relatives, friends, close friends, all they hate me hugely. And sometime only unknown people come and they praise me and compliment me. So that is what I mean. Common, I think, in society also that is a normal trend.
So maybe you may need to rethink about the way you are writing. So in order to get attention from the outside, you use the right hashtag to attract people onto your LinkedIn.
No, presently, you see, I'm not interested in going in that direction, attracting people, because last 20 years I have seen it. I am a hopeless attractor. I mean, I'm unable to attract. I don't want to attract anymore. What I want basically, can I get a good partner in my whole endeavor? You see, are you getting business partner or a professional partner? Something like this. Whatever. Suppose I am a writer, if I can get a publisher, if I can get a distributor, something like this.
The thing is that I guess as far as the large
not a fan, because I find most of the people are idiot. They can't write a line, but they abuse a paragraph. Are you getting what I am trying to say? They can't write a line, but when they have to abuse, they can write anything actually. They write a paragraph, two paragraph, three paragraphs. But when they have to write anything good, they can't write a line. That is the problem. So that is not the problem. Problem is if the poor person like me comes from a poor family, poor background. You see,
so Baba, I need to drop out there. I need to get into another meeting. Sorry,
no problem. No problem. Yeah.
Okay, sure. Thanks.
Thank you, PR.
Thanks, sir.
Okay. And be in touch on LinkedIn or Facebook. Write your comments and we can take it forward.
Okay, sir. Okay.
See you. Nice meeting. Bye.
Thanks, sir. Yeah.
So the moment I started talking about right things, confidently, the listeners ran away, but no problem. The war is on, and I'm here to fight the battle. Thank you. With 3 books on unlearning, the journey will go on. But